Hello everyone, welcome to an analysis of Dance. We discuss the movements and debuts of the Billboard Hot Dance Charts in immaculate detail, with in-depth reviews of each debut each week. Well, I expected a lot busier week than this. I mean, given that Kim Petras' album was going to completely fall off this week, I'm not surprised that we did see a decent number of debuts and some pretty decent movements that show some promise for this chart, but it still didn't really feel as busy as most post-album bomb weeks have felt. That's all I'm saying. I mean, it's definitely busy, but not as much as I expected. And of course, the top 10 is where this didn't really matter at all, as I'm Good Blue by David Guetta and Bebe Rexha is still at number one. Although, given that it started to really fall on radio and streaming, the fact that this could actually be knocked off the top by anything that debuts in the top 40 of the Hot 100, yeah, that's kind of interesting to note, and also really telling. I mean, I gotta hope that comes soon, because Baby Don't Hurt Me by David Guetta and Marie and Coil Array is still at number two, but really, given that the radio's starting to stall out on this one, I'm not exactly expecting that this would go to number one anytime in the future, which I'm not complaining about. It's easily the worst of the two songs at the top. Then you have Trust Fall by Pink in number 3 and Hold Me Closer by Elton John and Britney Spears in number 4, as the former is starting to really get rotated out on radio and the latter is just remaining residual across the board and doesn't really have any strong categories to it. But then you have the three big revivals thanks to two big songs in the top 10 falling back a bit, with Bizarrap That Music Sessions Volume 53 by Bizarrap and Shakira at number 5, El Malengu by Marshmello and Manuel Turizo at number 6, and Padam Padam by Kylie Minogue at number 7. Really, I expect that last one to actually get more momentum going forward, which is a damn shame because it's easily the worst of the three here. But then you have those expected fallbacks for the two big debuts by Bizarrap and Rauw Alejandro, which really only lost hard on streaming, and given that both didn't really fall off the Hot Latin charts, I do expect them to actually have a decent amount of staying power. But for now, Bizarrap Music Sessions Volume 56 is at number 8 and Baby Hello is at number 9. Hopefully these rebound in the future. They're both really great songs. Unfortunately, what didn't exit the top 10 was Alone by Kim Petras and Nicki Minaj at number 10, which still somehow has streaming behind it. Seriously? This is what we're keeping in the top 10? Especially given that the Kim Petras album bomb just had no staying power at all this week? Are you fucking serious? I mean, thankfully I don't expect it to go any higher, but still, way to ruin a really promising top 10 by having this pile of shit in there to begin with. But anyways, falls and fall-offs, where alongside Kim Petras, we had Giga Chat Theme by Jioxx comfortably make its year-end list after 20 weeks, as well as Call On Me by Bebe Rexha. Thanks guys, you didn't let this one flop. Fuck off with that. But the losers also weren't all that surprising, or really all that interesting, all things considered. I mean, yes, I Like You by Tove Lo is continuing to just not stick around at 49, and Self-Destruction Mode by The Chainsmokers and Bloodnymph absolutely freefall to 37 as expected, but every other song on this list is a debut from last week. And really, outside of Drifting by Tiësto only falling to 35, which is really promising, it didn't fall that hard, I'm not really complaining about the rest of them, because they genuinely suck. King of Hearts by Kim Petras absolutely freefall to 27. Thank God one song from that album that stuck around this week actually collapsed. And if it's taken down See You Again by The Chainsmokers and Millennium featuring Carly Hansen to 23, and Como Yo by Marshmello and Tiago PZK to 48, yeah, I'm not remotely complaining about this at all. These songs were all amongst the worst of the pretty bad week last week. I'm not exactly complaining here. But what shocked me more were our jumps and comebacks, where we only saw two of each category this week. I mean, yes, Money on the Dash by Ellie Duhay and Wetham was going to rebound to 46. Again, it's just filling in a spot at this rate. But what shocked me was Do It All Again by Punctual and Jordan Shaw managing to come back at 44. I mean, I assume this is because of Spotify's autoplay feature giving this a big boost. Really, I'm not surprised at all given the song's sound. But this dropped out in February. Honestly, I'm shocked that this is back at all. And given that it returned pretty decently and the fact that it's at 11 weeks, I can't rule this out having a second run and potentially make the year-end list. Which, given that I absolutely adore this song, that's all but good news for me. I'd love to see that happen. Oh, and In Our Gains, Rhyme Dust by MK and Don Dollars at 33, and Relax My Eyes by Another and Abel Bolder is at 38. And yeah, these are both great songs. They're really only here filling in space from last week, and I'm not remotely complaining. Good stuff here, guys. But then we get to our debuts, and all of six of them this week, starting off with number 50, Brazilian Dancha Funk by Synth Main and Red Devil. Oh, dear God, are we seriously doing this again? I mean, it was only a matter of time before that Brazilian funk mandalão trend would properly cross over consistently, especially with its ties to funk music, which is still as popular as ever. But seriously, it's not like any of these songs are remotely good. So I had zero expectations for this, and I'll be honest, I actually liked this a lot more than I expected. It's probably the best of the funk mandalão songs that have crossed over so far. I think what mainly works for me here are the funk fusions that are added, especially in the percussion, which actually hits a lot harder than I expected, and it's actually decently mixed and has a pretty solid groove behind it. I think this is the side of funk mandalão that I can actually like, but when you make the mix actually decently produced and don't make the percussion sound as clipped and annoying as a lot of other songs in this genre, I can actually really get into it. I mean, yes, the production still has those problems from funk mandalão besides that, especially in the vocal samples, which sound really shrill, even despite actually being a lot more hype than I expected, and the mixing still not being all that great, all things considered, but then again, that's expected coming out of funk songs. But I actually like this a lot more than I expected, and really, given the low standards I have for this genre, the fact that this is actually decent is a really good sign. It's the closest to this style that I actually really liked, and really, I don't expect it to have much staying power, but the fact that crossed over all shows aside the genre that I can actually really like if it's built upon more. So yeah, this is perfectly fine. I might actually recommend it. It's a decent song. Yeah, I'm surprised about that. Number 41, Ascend by Dezco. Saw this song debut, I thought we were getting a new song from Dzeko of Dzeko and Torres. I mean, come on, the names are very similar here. Unfortunately, that's not the case, but this is actually a pretty promising new name coming out of Colombia, who's been building up a decent amount of momentum off this one song, which is his debut single and his only song on streaming platforms as of recording this. So hopefully we get another case like It's Murph, right? Well, actually, yeah, I can definitely see it. This is a really solid song. Yes, you can tell that this is very much a debut single. The production definitely doesn't explode as much as it should. Really, you could have made those drops a little bit more explosive and less dry sounding than what they are. You can definitely tell this was made by a newcomer. And I will admit that the song doesn't really have much in the way of progression and doesn't really sound the best coming out of Progressive House. But I still won't deny that it does sound really damn good regardless, especially in the synth production that just sounds gorgeous. Really, it's pretty straightforward for Progressive House, but it's given the mixing quality that a lot of songs in that genre do, and when you combine that with the female vocals that sound bombastic as all hell, and the drops that have a really nice atmosphere to them in spite of their flaws, yeah, I can definitely see the potential here. This guy's got a lot of talent in production, I will say that. So yeah, it's not properly great on the back of a few setbacks from being a newcomer in the scene, but this shows a level of potential and promise that I was really not expecting. And really, given that this is his debut single, I can only see him going up from here because the level of talent and potential is really there. So yeah, this is a really damn good song. I'd like to see where this guy goes moving forward. He's got a ton of promise. Number 40, You're Too Slow by Odatari. Okay, seriously, guys, can we stop giving Odatari charming songs, please? It was cute the first time with Narcissistic Personality Disorder, but now it's just becoming genuinely insufferable. I mean, thank God this one debuted low enough where I don't see it becoming a hit, and thank God for that too, because this is absolutely terrible. For one, how is it that a mainstream producer like Odatari can have such consistently bad production? The mixing here is atrocious, the farty synths overpower the song and sound really awful, the vocals are once again covered in so much reverb and autotune that you can barely understand what they're saying, which is really a good thing when you look at the lyrics for this mess. And the hook here is absolutely fucking terrible as it samples Sonic's You're Too Slow line. Yeah, I wish I was kidding. Combine that with the lyrics being repetitive as all hell, but still managing to fit in lines like I'm gone shit on you. Yeah, this is absolutely fucking worthless. It may not be the worst of Odatari's charting songs when Good Loyal Thoughts exists, but it's seriously down there. And again, why do we keep giving this talentless hack any sort of success after Narcissistic Personality Disorder? This song is absolutely fucking worthless. Skip it. Number 29, Heavier by Odessa and Yellow House. Planning collaborative EP here with South African folk singer Yellow House, and this is the lead single from it. I was honestly really excited given that I love The Last Goodbye, and To Be Yours has really grown on me since I first reviewed it, and wow, this is great. In fact, this might be one of their most cinematic songs today, which is really saying something. I mean, of course Yellow House sounds great. His willowy tone really fits well on this sort of production, and he has a sort of vocal range that fits with Odessa's bombastic sound quite well. But damn, I love how intense the production gets. The drums sound absolutely stunning against the blissful harmonies and synths on the drop, and the song has this massive atmosphere to it that makes it really sound like you're walking through a futuristic city. It's genuinely potent as all hell. I mean, there's not really a whole lot to say. It runs 4 minutes and doesn't really feel like it drags at all. And given that there's nothing here that I really dislike, yeah, this is genuinely great. And if this is a sign for what the EP has in store for us, I'm not complaining at all. This is terrific stuff. Check this out. Number 27, Car Keys Ayla by Alok and Ava Max. So you was the baby you were. I'm the bubbles in your champagne. Grip me tight like you're holding your cup. I'm the keys to your car, babe. So it seems like Alok's new formula to obtain hits is to sample old songs over and over again. I mean, I'm kind of mixed on this because I actually do like a lot of the songs that he's made hits out of this, but this formula can really run old if it keeps getting burnt into the ground, and unfortunately, this song is exactly proof of that. Now, it's not a bad song. The sample of the titular track by Ayla is really utilized quite well here and sounds nice against the heavier house production, but man, does this feel like a blatant retread of Alesso's When I'm Gone, especially when you have Ava Max on the song who really doesn't sound like she cares at all and kind of drags away from this entire sound for me. Combine that with the faster shuffling percussion and some underwhelming vocal melodies, it results in a song that's decently mixed, it's well produced, but doesn't really stand out at all, and again, given that Ava Max sounds checked out, why should I be engaged in this? I mean, it's not a bad song by any means, I get the appeal of this, but man, is it underwhelming and really has me worried for Alok moving forward. My god, I wanted to like this more. This is really disappointing. And finally, number 12, Volver by Tiny, Raul Alejandro, and Skrillex featuring Fortet. Surprised we didn't get more Tiny songs debuting this week. I mean, the album was definitely leaning more towards reggaeton than electronic, but given that this debuted and not that song with Bad Bunny that debuted on the Hot 100 but sounded more electronic than it, I'm honestly really surprised by that. I mean, of course this one was gonna cross over. It's a collaboration with Skrillex and Fortet of all people, but is it as good as the other Raul Alejandro songs that have charted? Well, actually, yeah, this is really damn good. Although part of it is probably helped by me being a fan of later era Fortet, because wow, that is a blatant sample of Lush from New Energy. One of my favorite songs that Fortet has ever made, and it absolutely works wonders here. The synth melody from that song is absolutely stunning, and when you put it over a really smooth reggaeton beat where it bounces off the percussion really well, it results in a song that has this really blissed out vibe to it. Tiny and Skrillex really do show their skills in this genre here, as it translates through different sounds ranging from hands up to traditional reggaeton, and all of it works really well. You could barely tell this was a sample at all, and if I wasn't a fan of later era Fortet, I wouldn't have even noticed. It's really well integrated. Combine that with Raul Alejandro being once again one of the most charismatic names in reggaeton, and the sort of production that really sounds exciting the whole way through and transitions through so many different passages. Yeah, this is a really fun song to listen to, and the fact that it debuted as high as it did, I can't rule out Fortet getting a second year and list spot this year. Man, 2023 has really been Kieran's year, hasn't it? So yeah, really damn good song, and even if I'm not sure if the album impact will make it actually stick around long term, I would love to see this become a hit. It's a really promising sign for reggaeton going forward. Check it out. And yeah, while Heavier by Odessa and Yellow House is getting the best of the week, Volver by Tiny, Raul Alejandro, and Skrillex featuring Fortet is getting the honorable runner-up, although that Desco song was actually really close to it. For the worst, yep, it's going to Oda Tara with You're Too Slow, Shock Horror, but dishonorable runner-up is going to Car Keys Ayla by Alok and Ava Max. Yeah, that Brazilian funk song actually managed to dodge the dishonorable runner-up. I actually liked it a lot more than I expected. That's really saying something. Next week, I have genuinely got no idea what to expect, as there's no real big single on the horizon that I can really see making a huge impact, so we'll have to see what crosses over. But yeah, that's all for this episode of An Analysis of Dance. See you next time.